like a student.
Because I'm sorry, I'm not there to see.
கடலுடுத்த நிலமடந்தை கையிலொழுகும் சீராரும் வதனமென திகழ் பரக கண்டமிதே இக்கணமும் அதிர் சிறந்த திராவிடனல் திருநாடும் தக்க சிறு திருமுதலும் தரித்தனரும் திலகமுமே திலக வாசனை போல் அனைத்துலகும் இந்த முறை எத்திசையும் புகழ் மணக்க இருந்த பெரும் தமிழனங்கே தமிழனங்கே உன் சீரமை திறந்து எந்த செய்ய மறந்து வாழ்த்ததுமே
Good afternoon, everybody. His Excellency, the Governor of Tamil Nadu, Professor Swaminathan, Father of Green Revolution in India, Sri Kamal Kishorji, Member, National Disaster Management Authority, Dr. Mohan Kanda, eminent scientist, invitees, friends, ladies and gentlemen. A warm welcome to you on behalf of Center for Good Governance, Hyderabad, and the National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayat Raj, again from Hyderabad. Welcome to you all for this function organized to release a book on disaster management in India, Evolution of Institutional Arrangements and Operational Strategies, authored by Dr. Mohan Kanda. Well, it's indeed a great honor to welcome Chief Guest of today's program, His Excellency, the Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri Roshaya Garu, beloved leader of Telugu people. On behalf of the organizers, may I request Ms. Usha to hand over the floral bouquet to His Excellency as a mark of our love, affection, respect to His Excellency. Well, Sri Roshaya Garu is a non-controversial. The government, even in the very difficult circumstances in the state of Andhra Pradesh. He is synonymous with finance portfolio, who has handled the state budget 16 times, including 7 times in a row, between 1979 to 2009, the 30 years span. Well, His Excellency has been MLC of the Andhra Pradesh Legislative Council for 3 terms. He has been a member of parliament. He has been a member of assembly. He has served as state Pradesh Congress Committee president, and he served as chief minister of erstwhile Andhra Pradesh. Well, as a proficient literary and social activist, he contributed various articles to Telugu and English newspapers on the issues focusing on the poor and deprived. We are really fortunate to have him as our chief guest today. Indeed, a rare multidimensional visionary. Once again, sir, we welcome you. Hearty welcome to His Excellency. Again, we express deep gratitude to His Excellency for sparing some time to release the book today. It's a great privilege to welcome distinguished guest, Professor Swaminathan, father of Green Revolution in India, and former member of Rajya Sabha. May I request Usha to show a mark of respect to father of Green Revolution, Professor Swaminathan. While Professor Swaminathan needs no introduction, but it is an honor for me to highlight the achievements of this gift to mankind. In the father of Green Revolution, again, he is well known to all of us. His vision is to rid hunger and poverty in the country and all over the world, globally. He served as the president of the International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. He has been recipient of the Ramon Magsaysay Award. He has been recipient of the World Food Prize. And he has been acclaimed as the one of the 20 most influential Asians of the 20th century by Times Magazine. Only three from India, the other two being the father of nation Mahatma Gandhi and Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore. We are very proud to serve. Warm welcome to you, Professor Swaminathan. Well, the former UN General Secretary, Javier Pérez de Cuellar, has described him as a living legend who will go into analysis of the history as a world scientist of rare distinction. Well, again, it's a great pleasure to welcome the guest of honor, Sri Kamal Kishoreji, the member of the National Disaster Management Agency. I request Ms. Geeta to hand over the floral bouquet to our guest of honor. Well, Sri Kamal Kishoreji has worked for about 22 years in disaster risk reduction and NDMA. He has served the UNDP for about 13 years in New Delhi, New York, Geneva, etc. Well, now it's time to welcome my mentor, Dr. Mohan Kanda, who is a well-known bureaucrat in the country. He has served as the Chief Secretary of the SVL Andhra Pradesh State. He served the Government of India in various capacities, including Secretary of Agriculture. May I request Mr. Shakti to hand over a floral bouquet to Dr. Mohan Kanda? Thank you, sir. We welcome you again. It's a mission to kindle the light in the lives of the affected people. It's a mission to help people to overcome the unforeseen event. It's a mission to think intellectually, act fearlessly, and maintain esteem among the affected people, irrespective of their caste, region, culture, sex, creed, etc. Dr. Mohan Kanda must be congratulated for sharing his lifetime experience in disasters and their management. Welcome you, sir. Thank you once again for all of you for having come here. I requested Professor Suman Chandra of NIRD to give a brief introduction about the book, please.
His Excellency, the Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri Roshaya Garu, our distinguished guest, Professor Swaminathan Garu, guest of honor, Sri Kamal Kishore Garu, Dr. Mohan Kanda, the author of the book, and my colleague, Devi Prasad Garu, and ladies and gentlemen. Let me take a few minutes to brief you about what Dr. Mohan Kanda has written in his book. Disasters disrupt progress and destroy the hoarded fruits of painstaking developmental efforts, often pushing nations in quest for progress back by several decades. Thus, efficient management of disasters rather than mere response to their occurrence has in recent times received increased attention both within India and abroad. This is as much a result of the recognition of the increasing frequency and intensity of the disasters as it is an acknowledgement that good governance in a caring and civilized society needs to deal effectively with the devastating effects of disasters. A sound disaster management system buttressed by a robust plan is the best preventive as well as mitigation strategy. The book titled Disaster Management in India, Evolution of Institutional Arrangements and Operational Strategies is one of its kind, which discusses the topics such as prevention, preparedness, relief and rehabilitation, reconstruction and recovery, risk assessment and vulnerability analysis, to mention a few. The book extensively referred to the Disaster Management Act of 2005, which came into existence as the Magna Carta of the disaster management. The book extensively covered both natural as well as man-made disasters, and also covered recent disasters such as Hudhud, Phailin, and Katrina, etc., in the form of case studies. The author, being an eminent administrator, recapitulated his past experience and with his experience enriched the subjects, such as the role of the different agencies covering national, international, and donor agencies in the implementation of disaster management plans. Apart from the government viewpoint, the author has drawn upon his added personal experience to make the subject interesting. The book is a timely guide for preparation of a sustainable framework for future generations and disaster management program implementers and policymakers, and also useful to the student community. I wish all the best to Dr. Mohan Kanda, who is the author of this book, on behalf of the Director General of Nations of Rural Development and Panchayat Raj, and also the Director General of Center for Good Governance. I would like to see many more writings on the subject in future. Thanks, one and all. Jai Hind.
The book, please. Now, may I request the guest of honor of the function, Sri Kamal Kishoreji, to address the gathering, please.
Good afternoon. His Excellency, Dr. Rasaiya, Governor of Tamil Nadu, Venerable Professor M.S. Swaminathan, Dr. Mohan Kanda, colleagues, it's been an honor to be here this morning and be part of this important occasion when a seminal publication on disaster management is being released. I'll just say two or three points about the relevance and timeliness of this publication. The first point I want to make is that there is a trend in India and globally over the last two decades that for most disasters, particularly hydrometeorological disasters, and in most parts of the world, there's a trend that mortality from these events is going down. Yet, number of people being affected, the economic losses are escalating exponentially. In our own country, we have done a very good job. You know, there is the case of Cyclone Phailin in Odisha, Hudhud in Andhra Pradesh, where the mortality was much lower compared to the previous events. But the number of people affected, number of people whose lives are affected by this, whose livelihoods are affected, is still not declining. It is still the same or increasing in most cases. So we really need to go beyond saving lives to saving livelihoods. And in the opening introduction of this, the book, you know, it was highlighted that disasters disrupt development gains, which means that now we need to work on disasters not as an issue of managing crisis, but managing risk. We need to go beyond crisis management to risk management. With it, the second point I would like to make is within our own country, the Disaster Management Act of 2005 was referred to as Magna Carta of disaster management. It is indeed true. In my job with NDMA for the last 1 year, every time I look at the act, I really marvel at all the aspects it covers. You know, anything I want to sort of address, it is somehow or the address there in the act. But the success of its implementation really lies at the state and district levels and even local levels. The Act asks for creation of state disaster management plans and district disaster management plans. All the states have state disaster management plans. Districts do not yet have. The coverage is about 80% at the moment. And having a plan is also not enough. You know, you really need to have institutional operational strategy behind the plan to actually implement that in a meaningful and effective way. So to that extent, the title of the book, you know, the subtitle of the book, which says Institutional Arrangements and Operational Strategies, it sounds like music to my ears. I would really want to read it carefully, learn from it, and take it forward in implementing some of the things that are in there. And who can do this kind of formulation, conceptualization, a distillation of decades of experience than Dr. Mohan Kanda? So I'm very thankful that you invited me, sir. And I really look forward to reading the book and making use of it in my work. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
May I request Professor Swaminathan to give a brief address to the gathering?
Yes, I can. Thank you very much. Honorable Governor Dr. Hoseya Garu, Dr. Mohan Kanda, the author of this book, the other members on the podium, and those who have come here, friends. First of all, I want to thank both the International Institute of Rural Development and Panchayat Raj and the Center for Good Governance for choosing this institution for the release of the book. We will greatly value, and particularly requesting Dr. Hoseya Garu to release it, because he, in his long experience as Finance Minister, Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, sir, you have dealt with many disasters, and I know in all those cases you have earned a lot of credit from the people, the way in which those disasters were handled. I am also happy that the book has been written by Dr. Mohan Kanda, whom I have had the privilege of knowing for a long time. There is no one more qualified to write such a book on disaster management, because he has been in government, not only Chief Secretary of Andhra Pradesh, but Union Agriculture Secretary, Union Secretary of Rural Development, member of the Disaster Management Commission. There's nobody who has got such a wide range of experience, both in administration, in institution building, and the structures, who can write. I just had a copy this morning. I was looking at it. We went through a very difficult disaster in the Chennai. 2 months ago in December, we had a disaster. And a post-mortem analysis, can it be avoided, what can be done, and so on. Naturally, I think every disaster is an opportunity for learning, so that in future we don't commit the same mistake. One of the points which came was the need for giving attention to the natural drainage points. You know, the new constructions and so on completely clogged the drains. With the result, the water, where will the water go? Of course, we are fortunate we are near the sea, so that water can go. But fact remains, every disaster, if you analyze it properly, then you can learn a lot of lessons and avoid the same mistakes in the future. For example, I recall with personal knowledge the super cyclone Orissa some 10 years ago. It was tremendous loss of property, loss of lives, loss of property, and so on. But then subsequently there have been similar very serious events, but they didn't lose any life. The management was excellent. In other words, learning from the super cyclone, subsequent cyclones were somewhat managed better. That's what happens when we always say, why are the loss of life confined to developing countries? Industrialized countries, they have also big natural disasters. But loss of life is very, very, very little, very rare. But in our country, it was not so until more recently. This is why it has been wise on the part of the Government of India to have developed and set up a Disaster Management Commission.
and people like Dr. Mohan Kanda were there with a lot of experience. I wish to say, after tsunami, for example, we learnt a lot of lessons. The issues, like we have got a program called Fisher Friend Application of modern technology, modern information technology. The main idea was that the small-scale fishermen who go to the sea, they will know in advance what the wave heights are likely to be and what the fish, where the fish will be. So we have also got new technologies, new methods of empowerment of people against disasters. But the fact remains that certain natural disasters, suddenly they come. Tsunami was a very sudden one. Suddenly they came and we are not prepared. But future tsunamis, I recall, you may say it's a false alarm, but nevertheless, there was a warning that tsunami may come, in which case people are prepared. The fishermen will come away from the sea and so on. So I think the book, I'm going to go through it very carefully. It has also dealt with institutional structures. Ultimately, it is not only the public should know, but the Panchayat Raj institutions, the various other institutions should also be equipped with the ability to manage disasters. In future, it looks as though with climate change and so on, disasters may become a little more frequent than before. We do not know. We do not know whether the present problem in Chennai was due to climate change. We don't know. But nevertheless, the fact remains, not only in Chennai, but many other parts of India, more drought, more floods, more cyclones, cyclonic storms and so on. So I think we need to equip ourselves very well with disaster management. I only hope that this book will be made a part of a syllabus of colleges, and it may not be for credit, a non-credit course on disaster management, because ultimately government can do its part, but the public and the enlightened public will have to take their own part. We made a study for the Government of India after tsunami. It is published a book called Post-Tsunami, The New Andamans. What all Andamans and Nicobar Islands, because they are very near Sumatra, the epicenter of tsunami. Therefore, they had more damage. But what all can be done in future that we don't have the same problem. So every analysis of every calamity, understanding how we can avoid the same problem, is a very important exercise. But for that we require tools like this one, this book. Unless we learn from experience, we can't do it. So may I again, once again, sir, thank you for agreeing to release the book and releasing the book. Thank you for both of the directors, good governance, and for choosing MSR for release of the book. And above all, Mohan Kanda ji, for taking the trouble to write the book. But many times, our knowledge remains with ourselves. People don't share it. But he was not in my case. So, and I hope will help enrich our capability to face disasters or other kinds of calamities in the future. Thank you very much for asking me to say a few words.
Thank you, sir. Every time your message is new. As a matter of information, sir, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh governments, both they have included the syllabus of the engineering colleges, disaster management, just about 2 years ago. Well, anyway, before we hear the chief guest's address, response from author of the book, Dr. Mohan Kanda, please.
His Excellency Dr. K. Rosaya Garu, Governor of Tamil Nadu, my mentor and guru, Dr. M. S. Swaminathan Garu, Mr. Kamal Kishore, and colleagues on the dais. Actually, I had specially arranged for me not to speak because I thought it would be proper. But the two institutions which really sort of footed the bill for the book, I can't say no to them, they hold the purse strings, so I had to say yes. Devi Prasad, while introducing the book and welcoming the guests, said that Professor Swaminathan has been described as a living legend. The living legend is really only an expression in English for most of us.
But if you want to see it in flesh and blood, I think it's really Dr. Swaminathan who is available to this generation. And it has been my privilege and an honor to have been associated with him for the last more than 2 decades in several on several occasions and in several fora. In fact, last year when I met him at the New Delhi airport, it just came out of me to ask him whether he would agree to release a book on disaster management. He said yes, and by then I hadn't even planned to write one. So it is after that I sort of forced myself to sit and pay it down, because as Professor Swaminathan very correctly put it, it's no fun writing a book like this. And the subject itself is literally soul killing, and to have to, you know, put together all the information and recollect the events one has been through, and the documentation in our country being generally of a very poor variety, to, you know, sort of, especially the case studies, and I'm extremely grateful for the help and assistance rendered by NIRD, PR and CJG for compiling all the information. And if Dr. M.S. Swaminathan is an example of what the country has benefited from the selfless services of great scientists like him, Dr. Rosegaur is another example of political sagacity, experience and wisdom. Through several generations of politicians have been schooled by him, and the art of transiting from being a political leader to a statesman is something he has really mastered thoroughly. I've always been the recipient of his kindness and his wholehearted blessings to all my ventures. He very spontaneously agreed to grace this occasion, and I'm extremely grateful to him. And in Mr. Kamal Kishore, I think if we should be grateful that in the past, for the several decades in the past, people like Professor Swaminathan and Dr. Rosegaur have been able to guide the destinies of our nation. I think it's, when we look to the future, it is young persons like Kamal Kishore, accomplished, enthusiastic and extremely talented and dedicated, who have left much greener pastures to come and serve their nation, that we look to you for, you know, guiding the country to a safe and prosperous future. And in the little time that I've had the privilege of spending with him, I've come back completely satisfied and hopeful that the country is safe in the hands of people like him. They will lead us forward to much better times. And it is really a tribute to the Government of India that they have chosen brilliant persons like him, who are also fired with the spirit of service and dedication to be in important positions like this. And I've always said, in fact I was mentioning to Professor Swaminathan, that if a baby is drowning and somebody jumps into a well and saves the baby, there'll be photographs in the newspaper, there'll be probably medals and things like that, a lot of visibility, glamour in that. In preparedness there is no such thing, because what was saved, we can never be, you know, sort of calculated, and no credit can be apportioned to anyone. Therefore preparedness has always remained neglected. And if one is to be able to achieve the paradigm shift which the Act has envisioned, it is absolutely essential that we institutionalize the phase of preparedness in the country through several measures, one of which I have discussed in the book, and I also mentioned it to Mr. Kamal Kishore in the morning. He was very receptive. In fact, I was surprised to find that work on that has already commenced. No wonder, you know, with people like him there, they will not let grass grow under their feet. I'm talking of the subject of disaster preparedness. Like in the whole world, there is what is called the Human Development Index. So countries, and within countries, different institutions and departments and individuals can measure and benchmark their progress over a time series of numbers over the years. And that it is that effort which I commended in one chapter of this book, and I hope to be able to see that happening in the near future. And of course, a separate vote of thanks will be forthcoming, but I am grateful to the NIRD, the CGG, the Swaminathan Foundation, especially the staff members, and to His Excellency Professor Swaminathan and Mr. Kamal Kishore for having agreed to associate themselves with this humble venture of mine. Thank you very much.
May I request humbly His Excellency Governor to give a brief.
A pleasant good morning. Dr. Mohan Kanda, author of the book, and a man who held different positions both in the state government and government of India with distinction. Professor M.S. Swaminathan, founder chairman, MSSRF, Chennai. Sri Kamal Kishore, member, National Disaster Management Authority, New Delhi. Sri Devi Prasad, Juwadi, Center for Good Governance, Hyderabad. Dr. K. Suman Chandra, National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayat Raj, Hyderabad. Tirumati B. J. Sri, head, the Hindu Media Resource Center of MSSRF. Distinguished invitees, members of National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayat Raj, members of Center for Good Governance, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to release the book on disaster management in India, Evolution of Institutional Arrangements and Operational Strategies, authored by Dr. Mohan Kanda, in the august presence of Professor M. S. Swaminathan, agricultural scientist and father of Green Revolution. Disasters, natural as well as man-made, halt the progress and are a hurdle to the socio-economic development. Globally, there has been an increase in the number of disasters. United Nations Statistical Yearbook for Asia and the Pacific 2014 reveals that Asia and the Pacific is the world's most natural disaster prone area. It is worrying to note that the disaster related deaths in the Asia Pacific region rose more than threefold in the past decade. United Nations Disaster Risk Reduction Report states that India is one among the five countries which was struck by highest number of weather-related calamities over the 20-year period with 288 disasters. It also indicates that weather and climate are the major drivers of disaster risks. Our country is among countries having the world's most disaster-prone area, and about 85% of it is vulnerable to disaster. Studies reveal that almost 57% of the land is vulnerable to earthquakes, 68% to droughts, 8% to cyclones, and 12% to floods. The Indian continent is said to be the worst cyclone-affected part of the world. And cyclones strike east coast of India along the Bay of Bengal, states of West Bengal, Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, and parts of Maharashtra and Gujarat on the west coast. The concept of management is not new to us. In recent years, India has been witnessing a paradigm shift in disaster management from a relief-centric approach in the past to current holistic one involving disaster preparedness and mitigation encompassing all facets, to prevent loss of life and property. Creation of public awareness aimed at preparing them right from the onset of a disaster is imperative. Roping in various NGOs and voluntary organizations is necessary in disaster preparedness. The more that can be done to reduce the effects of a disaster, save loss of lives and property, less there will be problems in the aftermath of the disaster. The author, Dr. Mohan Kanda, lays emphasis on the importance of prevention of land prepared, prevention of and preparedness of for disasters. He states in his book that during any disaster, communities are always not only the first to be affected, but also the first to respond. Community participation ensures local ownership, addresses local needs, and promotes volunteerism and mutual help to prevent and minimize damage. Therefore, the efforts of the states, union territories, in this regard, need to be encouraged. He further states that as first responders to any disaster, communities should be trained in the various aspects of response, such as first aid, search and rescue, management of community shelters, psychosocial counseling, distribution of relief, and accessing support from government or private agencies, etc. Dr. Mohan Kanda, IAS, former Chief Secretary, Andhra Pradesh, has been associated with me for nearly 3 decades when I was a minister and the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. He deserves commendation for writing this book based on his experiences as member National Disaster Management Authority. In his book, he introduces and discusses contemporary topics of disaster management with a touch of his far-sighted approach and rich experience. In essence, the book aims to provide the reader a broad perspective on disaster management and its status today in India, striking a balance between content and case study. I am sure this book would enlighten one in handling and managing disasters effectively and efficiently. I wish Dr. Mohan Kanda comes out with many more books in various fields he has served. Sri Mohan Kanda was in the government of Andhra Pradesh, government of India, holding several positions. When he was in Andhra Pradesh, I had the privilege of working with him in many departments. He's a very brilliant officer. He works and takes his colleagues also with him to work harder. I convey my warm felicitations to Dr. Mohan Kanda Athar and to the members of National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayat Raj and Center for Good Governance, Hyderabad. I conclude with the words of Frederick Douglass: man's greatness consists in his ability to do and the proper application of his powers to things needed to be done. The ultimate strength of a person is where he stands at times of challenge. It is this quality and inquisitive knowledge that will help us to reduce and alleviate the sufferings caused by disasters. My greetings to you all. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Very apt, meaningful message from Chief Guest. May I request JSC to propose formal vote of thanks, ma'am.
On behalf of the Center for Good Governance and the National Institute for Rural Development and Panchayati Raj, and on behalf of the MS Swaminathan Research Foundation, it's my honor and privilege to propose a vote of thanks. First and foremost, we would like to thank His Excellency, Sri Rosai Garuji, for having come here to the foundation to release this book and to be here on this important occasion. Sir, your remarks about how it is important for us to take charge of disaster so that our progress is not halted is something which is very, very important and a good take-home message for all of us. We'd also like to thank Sri Kamal Kishorji, member NDMA, who's taught us how important it is to differentiate between risk management and disaster management in terms of crisis. So we'd like to take this as a next step of action forward as a message from Sri Kishorji. So thank you very much. Professor Swaminathan, our guide and our mentor at all times, and recalling the recent instances that have shaken Chennai and parts of Tamil Nadu, which is so close to us and to which we can relate. So we look forward to further guidance on disaster preparedness and how important it is for all of us to take these messages forward. Dr. Suman Chandra from the National Institute of Rural Development, sir, thank you for your presence and for being a partner in this initiative in putting this book together. And, of course, the author himself, Dr. Mohan Kanda, we've heard how he's an ideal person to actually write the book, and we'd all be very interested in reading more about it and to understand how we can all prepare ourselves with knowledge. Sri Devi Prasad Ji from the Center for Good Governance, who's been working towards putting this entire program together. So thank you for all your efforts and for all the initiative you have taken in this process. I also have a list of names that the Center for Good Governance has requested me to thank. The DGs of the Center for Good Governance and of course the National Institute for Rural Development, the two co-organizers and partners of this event who have put the book together, who are bringing out this book. Thanks to them. We'd also like to thank from the Governor's Office, the ADC, and as well as the Officer on Special Duty, specifically for their support. We'd also like to thank from the Center for Good Governance, Mr. Venkatraman and Mr. Avinash. And we'd also like to thank from the Foundation itself, Dr. Selvam, Executive Director, MSSRF, is not here. He's had to be away on travel, and that meeting too is in connection with disaster management. You know, it throws focus on how important a subject this is, but he sends his best wishes and regards for the program. Ms. Reena Epen and the entire admin staff who have supported the putting together of this event, Ms. Malati at Professor's Office, who has been coordinating closely on this, as well as to all the others, the technical staff, who have helped put this together seamlessly. Thank you to all participants for being a good audience and for taking home this message on disaster management. I do hope we look forward to more wisdom from the book itself. Thank you one and all. There is a request from the organizers that they have very kindly hosted lunch and that you may please join them. Thanks again to one and all on the dais, and request you to stand for the national anthem, please. China.